The technology of warfare is in constant flux. I mean, there weren't even drones as we know them until late in the last century, and now, release the swarm! Hey there, friends. Trace here for DNews. Military technology has been a driver of innovation for centuries. Scientists keen to see their research funded have been recruited into government programs and helped create some truly fearsome technology. In the last few weeks, we've seen a number of pieces of military tech that have given us the shudders, to say the least. For example, in January 2017, the Pentagon announced that they'd successfully launched 103 micro-drones from fighter jets. A drone swarm. In fact, according to the Pentagon's statement, the 103 micro-drones are kind of like the Zerg swarm. They're, quote, not pre-programmed synchronized individuals. They are a collective organism, sharing one distributed brain for decision-making and adapting to each other like swarms in nature, end quote. Let all those who oppose the Overmind feel the wrath of the swarm. The modern unmanned aerial drone was first imagined by Nikola Tesla in the 1890s. Now, more than 100 years later, we've created a Hydra-like swarm of 6-inch autonomous vehicles that could, according to popular mechanics, jam enemy communications, form an ad hoc communications network, carry explosives, trick or jam enemy radar, and even attack individuals. The terrifying goal here is to create the drones in batches of 1,000 and be able to launch them from fighter jets or large cargo planes. Of course, in this crazy pants future, we would need a way to fight drones, right? So why not lasers? It's the future, right? In December 2016, the Department of Defense announced a 51% budget increase to $328 million for directed energy weapons. It's fancy budget talk for lasers. The DoD's research group, DARPA, has been working on laser weapons for a long time. They tried mounting lasers inside 747s, but they were relatively slow and not particularly accurate. The Navy mounted a laser on the USS Ponce, which uses heat energy to destroy drones and other targets. The Army has a laser on the back of a truck that can attack drones and mortars. And the Marines are working on a Humvee-mounted laser of their very own. Of course, this new research is still classified, but with such a sharp budget increase, there must be something going on. Lasers are still bulky energy hogs, but in an email to Seeker's own Eric Miller, the director of Directed Energy Professional Society, said the biggest issue is just getting the military to actually use lasers. I mean, if we can shoot a drone with a bullet or other traditional projectile, why use a laser? There is one obvious reason: pollution. Lasers are energy, but a bullet, it leaves behind a casing and the lead from the projectile itself. And it's not just bullets. Shell casings from grenades and explosives are left all over war zones. Over time, metals from bullets and casings can pollute groundwater and poison the soil. Once in the environment, lead causes damage to the brain, blood, kidneys, heart, and reproductive organs, and can kill wildlife too. Even though it sounds hippy-dippy, the DoD does have a solution: biodegradable, lead-free bullets. Sadly, not the actual small bullets, just 40 and 120 millimeter sized casings to start. They're used in mortars and tanks. The US Army Corps of Engineers has developed and tested bioengineered seeds that can be embedded inside the shells that grow plants after they've been left in the soil for several months. Those plants can then absorb chemicals and contribute to the rehabilitation of the war zone. Yeah, the US Army could shoot shells that result in new forests. Warfare of tomorrow may not be terminators or matrices. Instead, we might be shooting lasers at swarms of unmanned aerial drones, and if we do have to fire a bullet of some kind, it might leave behind the seed for new life. Future's weird. One thing is for sure, scientists will keep working on projects that push humanity forward, and sometimes it will be thanks to war. For example, ex-Nazis and Jewish scientists were responsible for getting us to the moon. Amy has the story for you here. How do you feel about these technologies? Do you have a favorite? Tell us in the comments. Please subscribe for more DNews, and thanks for watching.